So how do you plan your GRE for the next 3 months, right? So there is a theme which I have followed in this plan, if you notice. And the theme is prepare and fail fast, assess and then repeat. Okay. And what do I mean by that? What I feel is, and this is something I personally have done, I prepared for just like about 30 days. So I have extrapolated my 30-day plan to this 3-month plan, right? If you guys know, I also have a video on our channel talking about how to score 320 in just 30 days. So if you're someone who wants to look for that plan, definitely go and check it out. But essentially the theme is you would want to prepare some part of the exam, give the exam, see how you're doing and assess and move on, right? That way, what happens is you get quick feedback and you're able to quickly improve on your weaknesses also in terms of exam, right? So that's the overall theme. So how do we put it in work, right? So I think if you're planning for GRE starting from today, let's say, for example, one of the toughest things I feel most of, and this is kind of like a general opinion that people have in GRE from the perspective of GRE, is words. So I feel that is the first thing you should definitely tackle. And one of the key things about learning GRE vocabulary is habit, right? You would either ways have to form some habit for each of these sections, but you, the most important habit that you need to form is an habit to prepare words every day, right? At least 30 to 50 words every day. You can pick up any list. You can pick up Magush's word list, or you can pick up a Barron's high frequency word list, anything, whichever you would like. Okay. But pick up a list and focus on doing at least 30 to 50 words a day. Okay. And that is the habit that you, that is the key habit that you want to build in month one. Okay. Now, let's say this is the most important key takeaway from month one. Okay. Now let's say you understood this, you started building this habit. The first thing that I always recommend everyone is to give your mock exam in PowerPrep, right? When you get a PowerPrep account, you get 2 free exams, right? So give one exam. I know you haven't done any preparation. You haven't done, you haven't even started to looking into things, but I think the first thing to really understand is the exam pattern. Understand how the timing works, understand what is important in exam and what is, we feel it's more important, but it's not that not at all that important. Okay. And understand the scoring. Okay. Now, once you give your first mock test, okay, this will give you a score to anchor around, right? It will be a score which you will refer throughout your preparation, right? Whatever you get, don't judge yourself. This is just a score just for you to get familiarized with the exam and just to see where you are right now, just without doing any preparation, where you are, what are your, some of the good points or pros and cons kind of thing, right? Of your current understanding, right? GRE is pretty, I mean, the GRE quant is pretty simple. Most of the folks find it pretty simple. I was one of those who found it difficult, but I have seen most of the people find quant easy compared to verbal, right? But give your mock exam first, okay? Here I have mentioned that give a mock exam in week 3, but if you can give mock exam on day 1, that's also fine, because that's how I did it. And I've found that once you have a score and once you have an understanding that, okay, I'm able to get this much and this much in GRE verbal versus quant, so I know, okay, where I need to work. Okay. Another thing that you want to form right at the beginning of your preparation is find a study group or some study partners, right? This is going to be, since this is like a 3-month plan, I would say plan having study partners or having a study group will really help you, in the sense that a lot of times you will find tools and tips which your partners are using or which the group is using applicable to you and helpful to you, right? So definitely find a study group, find study partners, okay? I would also recommend you to set a goal for your scores in both the exams in your first month, okay? Ideally, I recommend 320 plus in GRE and about 100 plus, at least minimum 100 plus in TOEFL, okay? These couple of scores will put you in a very, very good spot from the perspective of choosing universities, okay? You will have more options if you are able to land these two scores, okay? Now, once you have done these three key important things, okay, you have given the exam, you know your initial scores, you have formed a study group, or you know a couple of folks who you are going to work with, you have understood the GRE format and everything, I think that's when you start applying. That's when you start focusing on individual sections, right? So you know in GRE. So now let's say you start with GRE verbal, right? Even within verbal, there are few sections, right? There's text completion, there are RCs, and there are some other stuff, right? Do you want to really master different question types so that you are able to really practice specific strategies to solve those questions, right? And then you will be able to have goals specific to those specific type of questions. So one of the things which I always see people mess up is text completion, right? A lot of times people are not able to get good at those because of the vocabulary, okay? So I see, but that is one of the easiest scoring kind of, it's the lowest hanging fruit. That's how I say it for you. So definitely master text completion. You should at least be able to get 7 out of 10, right? The third type of text completion, which is like the three blanks, don't worry about them. I feel a lot of times we stress more on getting those three right than stressing more on getting the twos and the ones right, you know. In fact, where all of these are given equal importance in terms of score, all of these are 1 point, right? So plan your time also accordingly. A lot of times folks end up spending a lot of time on the three blanks or two blanks, and it's for the same amount of marks, right? So I see one of the key goals which I recommend people is to get all the one and two blanks right, right? That should be at least your minimum goal in the text completion, right? In the first month, I would also recommend at the end of the month, maybe in the last week, try to write a couple of essays, one of each type, right? So that you are able to at least get familiarized, get understanding of what are some of the templates that you can use to solve each of those types of questions in essays. Right. You would also allocate some time to prepare quant, right? I think there are 15 to 20 topics, so you can keep a goal of at least finishing half of the quant topics, right, in the first month. That way, what happens is at the end of the month, you already have gone through one mock exam. You already have, if you follow the GRE vocabulary habit, you would end up at least with 900 to 1000 words, which you have at least seen once. Not that you will remember everything, be ready to forget at least 50% of them. So don't worry about it. Just go through it, as you use it in your essays, as you see it, read it in the RCs, you will remember, you will start remembering them. Okay. So at the end of the month, you would be, I feel at least 50%. And if you do it well, at least 50 to 70% ready for the exam, okay? Except for some of the topics which you left in quant, okay? At least 50% you should be ready, right? And how do you execute this at a day-to-day level, okay? Right? I want to elaborate a little bit on that. So let's say now you know, okay, these are my goals for this month. I would say put in at least 2 to 4 hours a day into your preparation, right? One of the ways which I used to do is when I was I used to prepare a lot of words when I'm traveling, right? I was working in industry when I was preparing for this exam. So when I was traveling, it used to be like a 45-minute bus ride. So I used to prepare words. I used to revise those words during lunch. And then while I'm coming back, you should do the other part of the words, right? This helped me. So figure out some pattern for yourself where you are able to do 30 to 50 words a day, right? I used to put focus time of about 2 hours into preparing at least either quant or verbal. Okay, whatever is the focus, whatever is my focus for that day. Okay. So that is how I used to plan every day. The third part of the part of my daily plan was trying few examples, right? So let's say I'll give you an example. So let's say I practice text completion today. Okay. One blank. Now what I will do is I'll prepare for 2 hours. I'll practice them, practice. Now, if you know, there are a lot of online free websites where you get exams, which is just focused on one blanks, exams, which is just focused on two blanks, right? And these are free. So what I used to do is I used to spend at least an hour to go through these specific exams. That way I'm able to count, okay, out of 10, how many I'm able to get right. I think with Power Prep also, you get certain number of free exams. So check that. But essentially what you're trying to do is you're trying to test yourself for what you prepared today. This way, what used to happen is I used to get that feedback, get that understanding earlier where I'm going wrong or what I need to change. Okay. So this is for month one. And hopefully this helps you. If you follow this, then going into month two, you just have to repeat what you did in month one, but with more mock exams. Okay. You would continue with the words. Now, a lot of people prepare less words. A lot of people prepare more words. How many words do you need is dependent on you. You know, you just need enough to, you know, crack the exam. It's not like we are going to, I know I have a friend who works in Apple now. He said this to me, this one funny thing he said. He was like, in GRE, you will prepare the words which you have never prepared, okay? Which you have never used before you planned for GRE, and which you will never use again after you give the GRE, okay? So don't worry about, don't get hung up with the count, word count. I have seen a lot of folks who are very good in reading. They have been reading throughout their life. So a lot of words they come very easy to them. People who are coming from, convent schools or English medium schools, they have better vocabulary compared to, so I came from Marathi background, like a Marathi school. Okay. So I didn't know nothing. So this plan is for someone who is coming from the bottom of the bottom. And that's how it applies to everyone. Like if you're coming from convent, this would be much easier for you. Okay. Just in terms of vocabulary or the RC part. So you finish your whatever number of words that you decided. Ideally, I feel 1000 to 1500 is a good one. If you really are crunched on time, let's say you only have 1 month, which is not the case with most of us here, then I would recommend maybe top 800 or 500. Okay. Because that's how much you don't have just time to remember all of this. It's very difficult. I mean, I find it difficult to remember all the words. So keep a goal of about 1000 to 1500. You will end up remembering about third of them, 500 or so. Okay. In month two, finish your quant remaining topics. Okay. One of the key books which I always recommend is Phi LB. Manhattan, Phi LB. Okay. That's a perfect book, I think. And there's a PDF online which you can download. Definitely you can follow that and, you know, prepare most of the topics. Okay. I personally used it. It was good enough for me. So finish your remaining quant topics and give your second mock exam. Okay. Now you want to make sure that all the mistakes which you did in your all the mistakes or all the preparation that you have put in all of this, this second exam is now pretty, you want to give a lot of importance to this second exam, because now you have prepared everything and you would want to actually score the your target scores in this exam. So let's say you decided, okay, I want to score 325 in GRE. Ideally, you would want to score that here in your exam too. Mostly, you will not be able to score it, because if you see, you just have put in, there is some time, there might be some topics which you are still working on, or you will still have some things which you would still be working through. So you might not hit your target, but you should be pretty close to your target in your second week exam or your second mock exam. Okay. One of the key tips which I learned from one of my conversations is, let's say you scheduled your exam in the morning. Okay. Actual exam, let's say 9 to 1. Okay. Give all your mock exams on the same time so that you are kind of mentally already going through the same setup. That just, you know, makes you a little bit more comfortable in your actual exam, because you are practicing at the same time over the weekends or around the same time. Generally, you would give exams over the weekend because that's when you have most of the time. But key thing is, practice it at the same time as you have your actual exam. Okay. So now, once you have given your second exam, that's when now we want to focus on what are some of the key things you want to really refine. Because now you have prepared most of the stuff, you know, you're done with preparing your verbal, you're done with preparing quant. Now you want to really identify what are those top three topics where you are going wrong in each of the things, or topics, or it could be mistakes, right? I'll give you an example. One mistake which people do is, in text completion, they spend a lot of time on the three blanks, you know. So what happens is, you get a three blank and you just end up spending like 2-3 minutes on that three blank. Okay. But ideally, you should give 1-1.5 minutes to per question, right, in your exam. So what happens is, you would end up rushing in your RCs. In your RCs, you have less time. Okay. So you might notice that in your second exam. Okay. In first exam, you wouldn't notice anything because you are pretty casual. You're there just to get used to everything, and you are just casually giving the exam. But in the exam two, you're pretty serious. You will notice the issue. Okay. Another issue which people feel is people face, and I have personally faced this, is in the RCs, there are certain types of RCs where we have to choose multiple right answers. A lot of times we end up spending a lot of time in those type of questions, you know. So definitely try to identify your top three mistakes or top three areas where you're kind of struggling in each section of the exam. Okay. And then for a couple of weeks, just focus on mastering those parts. Okay. Now, specific efforts on just fixing those things, right? Try new methods of solving the question. Share this in your groups, study groups. That way you are able to, you know, get strategies which other people are using and try them. Okay. And try to fix those things. Once you fix that, that's when you give your mock exam three, right? Mock exam three is when you already know everything. You have fixed most of the things where you're going wrong. And now you must be almost fully prepared for the exam. And that's when you give your mock three exam, right? That is in week 8. Okay. So again, the goal for this exam would be a little bit more than your last exam and as close as possible to your goal state, like whatever was your goal score. Okay. And ideally, you should be able to land to your goal score in this exam because of the actions that you already taken and the time that you put in. right? If you are really good at math, I recommend 170 out of 170 in quant, because a lot of times I have seen people struggling a little bit in the verbal section. So getting as much as possible, which is like that, if possible, get the max in quant, it really eases some pressure on your verbal section, right? Like imagine you scored just like 5 marks in your verbal, right? So 145 in verbal and you have 170, right? So still you land up at a pretty good score, right? So if you're good at quant, keep a goal of 170 out of 170. If you're good at verbal, definitely similar goal for verbal, okay? But that should be goal for month two. For month three, all we are trying to do now is just filling the gaps, okay? Just filling in the gaps, wherever we are feeling, okay, this is the specific part where I'm going wrong, or that is the specific part where I'm going wrong. Go through the words that you are missing. You keep missing those words, right? Revise through the key formulas, revise through the key tough words which you keep missing, right? Fix your timing issues. Ideally, you should fix your timing issues after exam three. There will be small timing issues which you will see. So fix them. And that's when you can give an exam. If you see, you will increase the frequency of exams after, you know, week 10, kind of week 10, 11, 12. You can give an exam every week. And then finally, you know, whatever score you get in your mocks, I have seen about +5 to 7, -5 to 7 is where you will land. So if you keep a goal of about 320, 325, +5, you are at a very good score. You are still at a very good score, right? So this is the whole plan, right? I think I want to spend 1 minute on the essays. SS is I think I need to mute something. Okay. So I feel SS is one of the underestimated section of GRE. So I would say, and this is something I missed in the month two. So in month two, you want to at least write 3 essays for each type, like both the types of the essays, right? 3 for first and 3 for second, right? That way you are fully prepared for SS. This year I talked with a lot of folks who got a very good GRE score, but their SS or their AWA score was below 3, and that just breaks my heart, because you studied so well for these two sections, and a lot of times they don't spend enough time, they don't give enough, they just feel that okay, they will be able to figure it out, and they end up scoring less in AWA, and that just screws up the whole thing. A lot of universities have AWA specific requirements, like they want your AWA score to be more than 3.5 or more than 4 or at least 4. So this is key thing. In second month, you want to at least write 6 essays in total, okay? And it's about 30 minutes per essay. So plan it over a weekend, or plan it over a day. Every day you spend like 30 minutes on one hour on one each type, like kind of 30 minutes on first, 30 minutes on the second. So that will really help you, okay? So hopefully this helps. I know this meeting is going to end in 4 minutes, so I'm going to quickly share a few GRE tips, and then we will drop off. I'll share another link and we'll go into the TOEFL one, okay? TOEFL, and ask me anything. Okay, so now I really like to stress upon GRE vocabulary, because that kind of drives your score a lot. That affects, this one thing affects your score a lot in the verbal section, okay? And as I shared, it's all about habit. You have to build a habit of prepare. And this is another, you know, one level deep, going a little bit deeper, that one of the things you can do is you prepare words for 2 days, let's say Monday, Tuesday, you prepared 50-50 words. So you have 100 words which you prepared in 2 days. Third day, put in revision, you know, try to go through those 100 words just quickly. Try to see which are the words which are totally forgetting. You know, there are certain words which you like, are, yaar, did I even read this word? So don't worry about that. That's normal. Okay. But put in this habit. Start maintaining this list of words which you are forgetting. This is a huge thing, by the way. A lot of people don't understand this early in their preparation. But if you have this list, every week you can go back and revisit this list. That way you are able to remember them. Slowly you will remember them. Slowly but surely you will remember them. Personally, I found mnemonics is the best way to remember the words. Mnemonics and pictures. There are certain words which I prepared like 10 years ago. I have never used them, but I still know the meaning because of the mnemonics. Okay. There's a nice website, mnemonicdictionary.com, or there are a lot of apps these days, but use mnemonics or pictures to remember the words. You know, one of the funny thing we used to do, when I was preparing, I started using these GRE words in my emails, okay, work emails. And it was pretty funny because a lot of folks used to ping me on the private chat. Hey, dude, what is this? Why are you using these words? It's tough for us. But it was fun, you know, since I knew, okay, I mean, it creates a good impression, by the way. Okay. So it's good in a way. And we had a small group within our company who was preparing for, like, all our young folks preparing for GRE. And whenever we used to send emails, we used to use all the words, try to use some difficult word so that just to make their life a little bit difficult, right? If you really love reading, if you really want to do it in the right way, I feel Word Power Made Easy is a pretty good book to start with. The right way to learn about a language is to learn the roots, right? Once you know the roots, it will be very easy to derive the meanings of the words and whatever meaning it comes. So that's the method which is followed in Word Power Made Easy. It introduces you to the roots. It introduces you to how to actually put a word, right? So if you want that, definitely, you know. The last tip with GRE vocabulary is when you're giving your mock exams, when you're solving these questions online, note down the words which you have no idea about, okay? In your passages, in your text completion, you will get these words and you would be like, what the heck is this word? Even in the options, right, that you get. No, make a note of this because there's a high chance that this will be repeated in your exam. Okay. Use Magush app if you want. Right. Know the synonym antonyms. That's another easy way to remember more words by doing less. But hopefully this helps you guys.